Hey, hey, hey. Time for another Out of This World story from rSpace. Treat me like a game and I will show you how it's played. Her life crumbles whilst mine has never been better. I, 25 male, was dating my ex-girlfriend. Let's call her Jess, 24 female, for 4.5 years. We met at university and she was in my business management class. We got put together on a huge project for the semester and we just sort of clicked. And after we finished the project, I asked her out, and she said yes. Those first few years together were absolute bliss. We were all lovey-dovey with each other, and overall, everything just felt right between us. We rarely argued and never got into fights. We communicated clearly and openly with each other. I really thought she was the one that I was going to spend the rest of my life with. Hell, I was saving up to buy her a ring. But here I am. During the last half year of our relationship, she began to grow distant and was constantly making excuses on why we couldn't hang out together as much. Both of us, of course, were out of university and we had begun working full-time jobs, so I thought this was normal. Note, we never were living together. But then, soon enough, she was starting to turn down intimacy. For some background info, me and her have very high libidos. We normally would go at least once a day. I always wore protection and she was on the pill because neither of us were ready to have kids. Thank God. One night, we decided to spend the night at her place. I tried to initiate intimacy and of course, she turned it down. This was really beginning to piss me off and I voiced my frustrations to her, but she just said that she wasn't feeling comfortable with her body at the time and asked to give her some space when it came to initiating intimacy. I agreed and we both went to bed. Or at least she did. I just had this gut feeling in my stomach that something was off and I went to snoop on her phone once I knew she was asleep. Yeah, I know this is bad, but I don't regret it one bit. And found out that she was hooking up with her serial cheating ex, 24 female. Found messages, pictures, and full-blown videos of them screwing. The video screwing killed me. In those videos, she was acting and saying things that really made me look at her as nothing more than a waste of space and a whore. At that very moment, all I could feel was hatred towards her. I looked down at her as she was sleeping, and all I could feel was visceral disgust. I then took screenshots of all the messages and sent them to me, including the other pics she sent him. Not the videos, though. I couldn't bear to send those. I quietly took whatever belongings I still had at her apartment and took them out to my car and went back to my apartment. In the morning, she called me and asked me where I was, and I just gave her a quick believable excuse, and she bought it. Now, here is some background info. Now let me introduce you to one of my close childhood friends. Let's call her Julia, 21 female. Julia and I were really close throughout our childhood, through high school. Me and her brother are best friends. They live a block away from my parents' home and where I grew up. Now about a year after me and Jess got together, I returned back to my hometown for my cousin's wedding and began hanging out with my old friends, including Julia and her brother. During that night, she confessed that she still had feelings for me. I turned her down and told her that I already had a girlfriend. She was very understanding and apologized, and after that, we didn't really talk as much as I didn't want to give her any indications that I was interested in a relationship with her since I was dating Jess. She was fine with this and understood it with no issues at all. She doesn't use social media, so the only way we would talk is over iMessage. During that time, I took a lot of photos of all of us hanging out with each other again. I went back to university about a week later, and I showed Jess where I was and who I was with as she was interested in seeing who I hung out with during my trip. Whilst we were scrolling through images, a picture of me and Julia popped up. She began to ask questions about her and who she was. I already explained to her that she was a childhood friend of mine and that during the trip, she confessed her feelings for me, but I shot her down and I showed her the text messages to back it up. And overall, she seemed fine with that. About a year later, during a little argument we had, she confessed to me that she was very insecure about her body and that she grew very insecure after seeing pictures of Julia because Julia had a very slim figure and looked gorgeous. I did my best to calm her fears, but I think in the end, she never really got over that. Now back to the story. I messaged my parents back in my hometown and asked them if I could stay at their place for the upcoming week, as I have some important things to discuss with them, and they were worried but agreed. I've been telling Jess that I was going down to see my parents as I haven't seen them in a while, and I want to visit them, and she didn't bat an eyelid at that. I went to work and met with my boss and explained to him the entire situation, and I asked for a little break. And he told me to take as much time as I need and come back when I'm ready. I went on my way down there during the weekend and told my parents everything. They were truly disgusted with her actions, and my mom told me that if I ever took her back, she was not allowed at their house ever. I told my mom not to worry. I had enough self-dignity to not ever take her back. I then messaged Julia and asked if she and I could talk. She agreed, and I went over to her apartment. I explained everything that I found out about Jess. I don't know what happened, but I think at that very moment, everything kind of hit me and I began to cry profusely. Not only because I lost someone I loved, but the fact that I wasted so much time on her and I would never get that time back. Julia was there to console me throughout my entire breakdown. After a little while, I calmed down. She brought out some drinks and we just drank, watched movies, and played Mario Kart till about 2 a.m. At this point, we were both quite tipsy, to say the least, and I couldn't really go back to my parents' place. She offered me to stay the night, and I did. We went to her room, and one thing led to another, and we were making out on her bed. Just before we took off our clothes, she told me to take out my phone and to start recording. As you can probably guess, we did the deed quite a few times that night. The entire time we were doing it, Julia was yelling out derogatory things about Jess like, well, I can't really repeat what she said because it's kind of dirty, but stuff like that, you use your imagination. After our last go, I went and stopped recording and we went to bed. I woke up the next day to the smell of her making breakfast and we ate together. I asked her why she wanted me to record what we did last night, and she said that she wanted to help me get some payback. I never once mentioned getting revenge on Jess, but I guess Julian knows me pretty well and knows that I would want to get some revenge just for treating me this way. She told me to just send her the audio file from the recording and break up with her. She told me that she still has feelings for me and will wait for me to sort everything out with Jess. I told her I can't promise her anything, and she said that was fine. She just wanted me to know. After that, we said our goodbyes and I went back to my parents' home, and they were kind of worried asking where I was last night. I told them me and Julia were just catching up. My parents were relieved, but as my parents got ready for work, my dad had a small smirk on his face. Guess he knows what I was doing that night. I went onto my computer and downloaded the video from my phone, and edited the video to just audio and a black screen. Once that was done, I spent the rest of the weekend with my friends partying and having fun, as well as spending a lot of time with Julia, and maybe having intercourse a few times as well. This time, no recording. I informed my boss that I would be returning to work in about a week, and he said that was perfectly fine. Best boss ever! I then texted Jess that I knew she was hooking up with her ex, and I sent all the screenshots. My last message to her ever was, "Treat me like a game, and I will show you how it's played." And I attached the audio of me and Julia having sex and then blocked her. Over the next few days, I was getting spam calls and spam messages from a bunch of our mutual friends and her family. I sent them all the screenshots of the text messages that I had, and it was radio silence for the most part after that. Her parents called me and apologized for their daughter's behavior, and that was that. Where I am now, about 1 year later. I just had my 26th birthday with my family and girlfriend of close to 1 year, Julia, who is now 22. I recently got a promotion at my work, and Julia just moved in with me, and she is going to graduate in a little over a week from now. She transferred over to the university I went to for her final year. I have a constant workout schedule. I am now 5'11", 165 pounds, was always pretty skinny while I was growing up. I have never felt more proud of myself, and I feel genuinely cared for in ways that I have never felt before. Now for my ex. A friend told me that apparently she went through a huge crisis because after I dumped her, she found out she was pregnant, and her ex that knocked her up apparently ghosted her. I couldn't be the dad because I never went raw on her. She had an abortion, and her life has been a mess ever since. Has an alcohol addiction, and thanks to the video I sent her, she now has huge body insecurity issues that has ruined most of it, if not all of her relationships since. For her, I am the one that got away, and for me, she is the largest bullet I ever dodged. I still despise her because of those 4.5 years we spent together are lost and I can never get them back. But I am living my best life and I couldn't be happier. My one piece of advice to anyone who has been cheated on, never settle for someone that doesn't respect you. The world is your oyster. Go out and live your best life. Time for a few comments to tie this one off. Becca Buxby starts us off. I guess there is nothing inherently wrong with feeling like you want to hurt your ex in the exact same way she hurt you, but the fact that it's over a year later and you're not just focused on your happiness, but satisfied with her unhappiness and how you damaged her self-image is strange. Not that she doesn't deserve it, but it just comes across as a little obsessive. If you're truly in a good place now, stay there and forget about your ex. You're clearly still thinking about her, and wishing upon her downfall will screw up your karma. JJ Farrow says, "Revenge is a dish best served cold. #respect. I get tired of people who say, turn the other cheek, or cheating on a cheater is just as bad. This here is the way anyone who cheated should be dealt with. I only regret the fact that you didn't send her sex tape to her job. Friends and family as well. Julie is a beast, but watch out for that one. If you ever screw her over, she's going to come back at you with something even worse than what the two of you did to your ex. But as long as you're a good man to her, I'm sure you'll be fine. Our last comment comes from Jesse Fay. OP, don't think of it as wasting 4.5 years. Think of it as practice so you'd be a great significant other to your new lady. My hubs of almost 20 years was married multiple times before we met. He was 43 then. He told me I should thank his exes because each one knocked the edges off of him, teaching him how to be a better husband. I tell him he's a slow learner if it took that many marriages. Regardless, it worked. Each person in your life helps create the person you are today. Jess was a good practice relationship for the one that really matters.